When it comes to video conferencing, I often find it very difficult to follow along with a script or my notes or perhaps an agenda while juggling multiple windows. I don't want to have to open up something here like my Google Docs on a separate window and split my screen and follow along at the same time. I would much rather if there was something here within Zoom that made it that much easier. And good news, there is a recent feature called Docs, which is making my life as both a trainer, as a facilitator, and a host of many Zoom meetings so much easier. So, for example, I often want to follow a script or an outline, but I don't want to share that with everyone here within the meeting. I'm going to come down here to Docs, and I've already created something here called a kickoff meeting agenda. Now, in this example, I'm going to say open for myself. Of course, we can share this with all of our participants, and there's great value in that as well. But I'm going to say open for myself, and here on the right-hand side of my Zoom application, I have my agenda. No one else can see this, but I'm also not juggling multiple windows, multiple dialog boxes. I can come here, I can follow along with the agenda, I can make edits as I go, I can minimize or expand certain sections, I can do whatever I want, and no one else within this meeting knows that I'm following along or that I have this script right off of the side without the need of a second monitor or an iPad or having to minimize all of my windows. And I can adjust this. I can make it a little bit bigger. I can make it smaller. And if I want to share this with everyone here within my Zoom meeting, I can come up here and say share to meeting. And no more do I have to say something like, can everyone see my screen? I don't have to share my entire desktop. I don't have to worry if I'm using an ultra wide monitor, if people can see it or if it looks too small. They can see everything here. So let's dive in a little bit deeper on where you will find Docs, how you can create your own and make it that much easier to facilitate and use them within your Zoom meetings. So here I am within my Zoom workplace desktop app, and I recommend that you do this here. You do have access to Docs within the web version, but it's simply that much easier managing and creating your Docs here. From the home screen, we want to come up to the tabs up top, and you will see one called Docs. So here within the Docs tab, you will have a collection of any Docs which you have created before, and of course this blue button will allow us to create a brand new document. You'll have a blank canvas to start with. Now, you can create absolutely anything that you want or copy and paste from almost anywhere in the world. In fact, if you hit that /, you are going to see the full list of everything that you can add, whether it's a to-do list, whether it's a table, whether it's images and videos, even if you want to include code, if you want to import other web pages, you can do almost anything, including other Google Drive files. We also have something here within Docs called AI Companion. You're probably not going to be surprised about that, but this is a very, very helpful tool where you can quickly drum up a meeting agenda, an outline, make a summary, and do that all here within Docs. But if we go back to the Docs home screen, you can also see that we can start to create them from templates so that whether you want to put together a product requirement request, meeting notes, stand-up meetings, meeting minutes, you've got a large number of different templates organized by category here on the left-hand side for you to choose from. But let's take a look at a real-world example for myself. Of course, I train others on productivity and how to be more efficient and organized. So I've got something here called an email training outline. And this is just an example of what I might cover in a 1-hour training on email management. So I've got my different headings here. I've got the particular times because this session is going to start at 10 a.m. So I want to keep myself on track. As a trainer or as a facilitator, this is extremely helpful because I want to have this at a glance. I want to have this off of the side of my desk so I can quickly make those changes. And speaking of AI, one of the things that I love is that with this agenda, you can see that instead of just saying that this is going to be for 5 minutes, this is going to be for 10 minutes, I like putting in the exact time because that's what I'm going to be looking at. I'm going to be looking at the clock and seeing if I'm on time. But what I can do is I can come up to that AI companion and I can say, oh, for my next webinar, change the start time to 11 a.m. And all I'm going to do is give it that brief prompt, that brief set of instructions. And in just a few seconds, it's going to work on it. And check this out. It's changed everything to that new time. It's changed everything to 11 a.m. You see that the old one here, it hasn't replaced it yet. The old one was starting at 10 a.m. But the new one is going to start at 11 a.m. I didn't have to come in here manually and make all of these changes. It did it for me. So no matter what time of day I'm starting this webinar, I can have this working for me. I can either say keep at this point, or I can say, no, let's continue with this one at 10 a.m. This is what I'm going to use next. Now, if you have any questions about using Docs here within Zoom Workplace, or if you have your own tips on how you're getting the most out of Docs, be sure to let me know in the comments down below. Thank you so much for watching, and remember, being productive does not need to be difficult. In fact, it's very simple.